Hi, my name is Sagar Upredi. I am a third year PhD student at the Open University UK. This work has been done in collaboration with my supervisor David Song and collaborators from the Princeton University of Technology Australia. And this work is primarily about relevance, and relevance has been theoretically studied a lot in information science and retrieval. And just to sum up some of the theoretical viewpoints of relevance. So, relevance is basically a cognitive concept, part of our decision-making abilities. It's a basically a relation. It always relates. There's always the to word after relevance. So, relevance can be said as something as relevant to. And in the information science context, it relates information or information object to a context or a situation. Previously, it has been thought to manifest in different ways. Previous studies expressed it as topical relevance, cognitive relevance, situational relevance, affective relevance. Recent times, this manifestation is studied in terms of the criteria, judgment criteria, also called the dimensions of relevance, like reliability, understandability, novelty, interest, etc. And according to the stratified model, these different manifestations are considered as layers which interact with each other, and at each of these layers, the inference of relevance takes place. And so, the aim of our paper is to study this interaction between these different dimensions of relevance. And the main hypothesis is that relevance inference at each of these dimensions is dependent upon the consideration of other dimensions. And because of these layers of dimensions, the inference takes place at each of these dimensions, and which leads to the final, the fusion of these inferences lead to the final judgment of relevance. So the research question is how does the consideration of one dimension influences the consideration of another dimension, and can we construct a formal mathematical model of the user's cognitive state in order to make prediction about these interactions? Now, since relevance is established as a cognitive concept, so we turn to some cognitive concepts, some concepts from the field of cognitive science. One of them is called the preference construction, which states that cognitive measures means any measurement of the user cognitive state, like asking a question or considering, or the user considering to judge a document. So, the cognitive measures are not always predefined or basically being read out of memory. At times they are constructed at the point of interaction with information or when a question is being asked. These cognitive measures they change the cognitive state. So, for example, if you are asked the question, how is this presentation? Before the question is asked, there is no predefined notion about the presentation. But only when the question is asked, then that association in the mind takes place, and some answer, some feeling, some belief comes out. And to another question, proceeding it as what do you think of the presenter as a researcher? Now the answer to the question 2 will be influenced whether the question 1 was asked or not. Not only what was the answer to question 1, but whether the question 1 itself was asked or not. This concept of preference construction leads to some effects in cognitive science, mainly the order effect phenomena, where asking questions in different orders will lead to different answers. In terms of relevance, order effect has been studied in the presentation order of documents. For example, two documents, D1 and D2, if we show the users in different orders, it has been shown that the marginal probability of answering D1 as relevant, let's say D1 plus, is cannot be constructed from the joint probabilities of taking into account both D1 and D2. And also, this violates one of the basic axioms of the probability theory, that the joint distribution of events is defined with respect, irrespective of the order considered. And these order effects also have been investigated in multidimensional relevance. So, instead of showing documents in different orders, if the user is asked to judge the understandability or topicality, etc. in different orders, it has also been established that there is an order effect there. So in order to study this interaction plus building a mathematical model, we take inspiration from the field of quantum cognition, which is a new area which studies human decision making using the mathematical framework of quantum theory. So it doesn't posit that there is something quantum going on in the brain, nor is it related to quantum computing. It's just a mathematical model, and one of the underlying advantages of this model is that the joint probabilities calculated here in quantum theory in terms of operators, which are matrices. So in general, these operators do not commute. So the basic axiom of the Boolean axiom of joint distribution is relaxed in general, which helps us to explain and predict and model order effects in cognitive in many decision making experiments. And so for our experiment, we aim to study the interaction between relevance dimensions, and particularly we consider three dimensions: topicality, understandability, reliability, henceforth referred as V, U, and R. And our experiment consists of asking basically yes-no type questions to user about the relevance of a document with respect to each of these dimensions in different orders. So this is basically an experiment design inspired from an experiment in quantum physics, which investigates the quantum nature of microscopic particles. So in the top half of the experiment, so basically we are dividing the participants into two groups, and one group is asked questions in the order T, R, U. First asked question about topicality, then reliability, then understandability, and the other group is asked in the other order. And based on this, their yes-no answers, we can collect all possible probabilities of judgments, plus when the user judges the document as topically relevant or reliable or understandable. For the experiment, we consider three query document pair and a between subject design, because we have two participant groups. We use employ three participants using a prolific crowd processing platform, and the queries are picked from the correct data sets, and the documents we modify themselves, modify the documents ourselves, so as to introduce some uncertainty. So these were the three queries we used. Even the queries we select, because these queries don't have documents, don't have a fixed relevance of documents. So the documents for these queries will be subject to interpretations, and different people might have different viewpoints. This is an example for document design. We for the query about radio waves and brain cancer, we take a document from Google, the type shown in Google and Bing snippet. And so if you note, the URL, actual URL was hustlebuzznews.com, which is a new website, but I modified it to hustlebuzznews.com so as to introduce some uncertainty in the reliability of the document. Even the text below the URL, some more technical terms were introduced so as to make it difficult to understand. Again, so that there is no fixed users are divided between the reliability, understandability, etc. And So we need to represent the user in the user's cognitive state. And in quantum theory, the model, representation model is called the Hilbert space, which is basically an abstract vector space with inner product. And particularly we use a complex value Hilbert space, a complex vector space. So the user's state before judgment, represented by S, is a vector in that space. And also the judgment of the state of user when the user has judged a document topical is also represented by the vector T plus, and the vector T minus represents document not being judged topical. And so before the user is asked the question of topicality, we cannot say what will the user answer. So user is analogous to quantum theory, is supposed to be in a superposition of both these states. And only when the question about topicalities is asked will the user state collapse to one of these states. So before the question, we can only model the probability of the user answering the question about topicality is yes or no. So the coefficients p, the square of the coefficient represents the probability p square. So similarly, we can model the state with respect to understandability and reliability also as a vector, orthogonal set of vectors u plus u minus, and which can be represented in terms of the vectors about topicality. So basically representing one vector in different bases. And the important point to note is that in the representation of one of those vectors, let's say reliability, we have a complex coefficient. So it is a complex value vector. And in quantum theory, this complex coefficient is what accounts for the uncertainty and the incompatibility, basically the order effect part. So using the rules of quantum theory, we can calculate the probabilities which we collect from the experiment here. For example, the last line, the probability r plus given u plus d plus, that is first user's answers positively to topicality, then positively to understandability, and then positively to reliability. So that comes out to be a big function of u, r in the complex case. And based on these equations, we can calculate these the values of t, u, r, theta, r. So basically, we have constructed the Hilbert space, which is the model of the user's problem state. So the mere presence of the angle theta, basically the complex coefficient, shows that it is possible to model this type of data using the complex Hilbert space. Had the data been what is called classical, these coefficients would have been zero, and they would not have been need of the quantum-like models. So. And also the analysis of interaction. So here we study the effect of understandability and reliability in the first table. And in the last line, let's say we see that so the bold means statistical significance difference. So the last line, we see that for the probability r plus given u minus is quite different from the probability of just r plus. So that shows that when the users do not understand the document, their judgment of reliability is also good than if the understandability is not considered. Also, in the other case, so again, when the users don't judge the document is reliable, their judgment of understandability is low, which may be because if they don't consider the document credible, they don't invest the resources to examine the understandability. In quantum theory, we can using these vectors, we can construct operators. So using the outer product of vectors. So for example, for operators, we can construct operators for topicality and reliability. And the commutation of these operators, if it is not zero, that signifies that there will be order effect when these dimensions will be considered for the particular query document. So basically, which says that again, the joint probability between T and R doesn't exist because they will be different in different orders. So, and here, even though we have not calculated, we have not asked the questions about T and R in different orders, we asked about R and U. But still, from this model, we can predict that even for T and R, there will be an order effect. Just to summarize. So what we hypothesized and what we found in the results that the consideration of our relevant dimension, it does affect the consideration of other dimensions, of the judgment with respect to other dimensions. And the order of consideration will affect the final relevance. And we need some generalized probabilistic models like using the mathematics of quantum theory to capture this incompatibility in judgment. Because one of them is affecting the other, so you cannot jointly consider both the dimensions. So some of the implications of this research is that, so firstly we see that, order effects, they do take place between relevant dimensions or even between documents because of the uncertainty associated. So if there is no uncertainty associated with judgment, so if a document has a fixed relevance, then even if you show a document in different orders, the relevance will not change. It is only because of the uncertainty does the context of showing the relevance in different orders, this uncertainty is getting exploited. And so one thing can be that the user uncertainty can be removed or reduced by, let's say, showing information equation labels, which is for each document some scores of different dimensions are calculated, right, like reliability score or novelty score, etc. So seeing that can help the user to make their own, to not rely on their own perceptions, but to reduce the uncertainty related to the dimensions. And so other thing can be that because different order of dimensions lead to different judgments, so there will be an optimal order of considering dimensions, which will lead to you know, the best, which will lead to the best utility of judgment. So let's say for medical queries, where you know, understandability can be an important factor. So for a medical query, a low understandability for a document can affect the reliability. So a user might not understand the document, and this might affect the judgment of reliability. However, the opposite order, in the opposite order, it can be considerably different. So if for medical queries, the users are again shown some the ratings or some reliability score, which can so that they can consider reliability first and not understandability. So that can subsequently affect their judgment of understandability, and subsequently they might make a more informed judgment of the document. And so that these cognitive biases, because of the uncertainty, they don't hinder the judgment process. And also, in order to make large scale models, we need to start first classify the users and queries according to preferred dimensions. So for, let's say, that for some queries, there will be certain dimensions which the users will prefer first. Start judging documents based on those dimensions. Let's say for a query like visa to the United States, surely reliability is the first criteria which the users will consider. And if you could classify the queries according to which are the important dimensions. And also, not only depends on the queries, but also the users. So let's say for a query Game of Thrones news, some users will be, the cautious users will be interested in only documents which are reliable, authentic sources. There might be some adventurous users who don't care about the sources, they are just they just want to know about the different conspiracy theories, or they don't even, they will do even fake documents because they are just interested in different things about the concern. So this preference of dimensions is both based on queries and the users and a mixture. And using this research for large scale, building large scale systems, this third point can be the first step. So so these are some of the implications we can draw from the study of user behavior in multi-dimensional. So yeah, that's it.